Pakistan's army chief was making it very clear that do not drag Pakistan army into the politics.
Removal of an elected government in Pakistan has always been through the military establishment.
Now, unprecedented scenes have been seen in Pakistan over the last few days. On the one hand, there are the 11 opposition parties who've united under the banner of Pakistan Democratic Movement, and they're conducting mass rallies. First one was in Gujranwala and Karachi recently. They've dismissed the Prime Minister Imran Khan's civilian government as a puppet government, and they've said they've openly come out against Pakistan army generals, accusing them of installing this regime. How do you think the army is going to react right now? Do you think sacrificing Imran Khan is an option?
Sacrificing Imran Khan is an option. So that option may not be there, but I would just agree with some of the points raised by my friend Emil. One thing was that it was the consensus vote that was given by all political parties during legislation in the parliament, which gave Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa a second term in office. So, even after that, there have been behind-the-scene contacts, behind-the-curtain contacts between PMLN and the military leadership. And that was, of course, a number of leaders have been in touch with Army Chief. So just recently, almost a month ago, Army Chief held meeting with some of the key parliamentary leaders. And former Chief Minister of Punjab, Shahbaz Sharif, was also sitting in that meeting. Pakistan People's Party leaders were sitting at that meeting. And the information that came out of that particular meeting, that Army Chief was making it very clear, Pakistan's Army Chief was making it very clear that do not drag Pakistan Army into the politics. Right? So Army is definitely there. And one of the meeting was called in the context of elections in Gilgit, Baltistan, in which the Army Chief assured that full security would be provided, but do not drag Army into the elections politics. So, and I think other than Nawaz Sharif, it was also unfair on the part of Prime Minister Imran Khan, the way he had been naming ISI Chief and Army Chief number of times. I think more dangerous points were made by Prime Minister Khan in his last number of speeches, particularly one on last Sunday at Convention Center, naming frequently Army Chief, that whosoever is Army Chief, it doesn't matter, or whosoever is Inter-Services Intelligence Chief, it doesn't matter me. And previously, once he was asked by the TV anchor that, had you been in case of Mr. Nawaz Sharif during the Kargil crisis, what you could have done? And he said, I would have sacked Army Chief and the DG Inter-Services Intelligence. I think Prime Minister Imran Khan's tone and tenor towards military leadership is also very harsh. And as you said, that sacking Prime Minister Khan could be an option. I do not rule it out, right? If the things do not go in the right direction, in future there could be very, very big changes. But Karachi incident has raised a number of questions.
Are these opposition protests and statements opening the door for the re-evaluation of civil-military relations in Pakistan?
Basically, yes. The whole discussion has started. This discussion was not so mainstream because of technological advances. Even when you control the media, this discussion has gone mainstream. Two provinces, or rather three provinces now, KPK, Sindh and Balochistan, civilian leaders, people who represent those provinces have started now coming out and talking about their grievances since decades. And these grievances, if you look at them from a neutral point of view, are very valid grievances. The abduction of their citizens, usurpation of their natural resources, all those issues were issues that were, you know, the intelligentsia used to talk about them, but the common man now knows about them. That kind of narrative being set up, because it was very difficult in the yesteryears to have a political rally and then talk about the intervention of the military, because the military has spent millions and billions of rupees on this narrative that what will you do without the military establishment. So with that narrative has finally been broken to this small extent that now people are talking about the so-called dirty role that the, even the politicians are talking about it. But what next? I think the most scary part of what next is that any time the chief of army staff gets in touch with any politician, you know, people, the pro-democracy people are very scared that, you know, every time the chief of army staff talks to Maulana Fazlur Rahman, who's the head of PDM, his tone and his voice and his narrative, you know, changes a little bit. And the same goes for Pakistan People's Party. PMLN is the only political party that is not doing it so far. But let's not forget, the younger brother of Nawaz Sharif is the main broker of power with the military establishment. So, and the smaller political parties that are, you know, principled and that are not changing their stance even when the phone call comes, are just don't have the power to make a change.
Civil-military relations, there have been long debate on civil-military relations in Pakistan. My colleague has put definitely light on current state of affairs more better than me. Right, so definitely military's role will definitely continue. But now, 2 points. One, whether this keeping in view this Karachi incident, I think it's definitely an incident. And I've already said that an inquiry will be conducted and things will be sorted out. But as far as the whether this PDM, Pakistan Democratic Movement, would be able to remove Khan's government, I don't think so.